Friday morning, March 28th, 2014. The High Seas crew is busy packing and preparing. High Seas stands for Hawaii Space Exploration Analog and Simulation. The three men and three women are hours away from the start of their mission. 120 days of isolation in an extremely remote, 1,000-square-foot habitat on Mauna Loa, Hawaii, 8,200 feet above sea level. They can only leave the geodesic dome in simulation spacesuits. The object of the University of Hawaii at Manoa project is to research how teams of astronauts will perform during long-duration space exploration to destinations like Mars. It's estimated a Mars mission would take 3 years to complete.
Missions like this reduce the risks of going to Mars. By practicing here on Earth, rehearsing the things we need to do on a trip to Mars, we're making it possible.
The first High Seas mission in 2013 was a food study. NASA has now committed $1.2 million to UH Manoa for the next three missions. The focus of High Seas mission number two is crew cohesion.
They're going to be taking a whole bunch of different psych tests, looking at their mood, looking at how they relate to each other, looking at their cognitive skills and how they change over time. But we're also going to be measuring their performance.
The habitat will simulate a base on Mars, and each crew member has a role to play.
I'll be responsible for the safety of the crew, meeting the tasks and objectives, both scientific and daily functions.
I'll be focusing pretty heavily on psychological adjustment and team dynamics, group cohesiveness.
Maintaining equipment, knowing how things work here and there, being able to fix things quickly with improvised materials.
Except for the mission commander, each crew member is also working on a scientific project or projects.
We are going to be testing out some 3D printed surgical tools in isolated, confined, and extreme environments, essentially.
I will have an experiment where I will have lights and plants, and I will grow the plants, and once I've taken the data of the plants, we'll be able to eat them.
Repurposing trash and waste from long-duration space missions and converting it into useful commodities.
Not only does it make for a realistic mission, so the crew will have real work to do, but we'll be giving NASA really good bang for their buck.
Before the long drive up Mauna Loa, the crew gathered for a final first aid training course. The six were selected from more than 120 very qualified candidates from all over the world.
We all had to meet certain physical and health requirements. We all had to meet certain education requirements. We all had to pass a certain bar of experience too, and I think that's going to help a great deal.
The crew members will be providing updates via Facebook and Twitter. Just search for High Seas. The crew finally arrived at the habitat just after sunset in a steady rain with the temperature hovering in the low 40s. They battled the elements as they moved their supplies and gear inside.
Right now I feel wet, but I'm trying to imagine it's a Mars sandstorm. So it's a relief to finally get started. I've been mentally preparing for a while now, so I'm ready to get in there and get the mission going.
I still can't believe it. I'm still not realizing that we'll be locked in for 120 days, but very excited about it.
A short time later, the crew stepped into the habitat, their new home for the next 4 months.
Bye.
Waved goodbye and closed the door. The UH Manoa run mission is scheduled to end in late July.